look at Northfield's lineup, they have a ton of girls on the roster. They're long. Their first five are long, but their substitutes are going to be long as well.
Yeah, you're right. There's, you know, Eckert, the senior, starting is 6 foot. And when you look at their roster, you know, you see 5'8", 5'9", 5'7". So, you know, you got some long athletic girls on that field or on that court. It's going to be something that the Rochester Lady Beavers have had to struggle with all year.
Yeah.
And then they've seemed to overcome it for the most part. And I don't think tonight will be any different. It's just a matter of, I think, which team's got their head in the game throughout, you know, for all four quarters.
Yeah, that 18-point deficit looming over Northfield's head right now, losing that, I should say. It'll be Eckert and B. Pollock to jump center, and the tip is controlled by Northfield as Reed hauls it down to the backcourt, runs it around. Alexa Holland, bounce pass right side to Steven. She'll fire long three. It's no good. Make that Thompson. The rebound to Stasiak, and she steps out of bounds. Well, the guys are at home tonight with the Northfield Norse, and we're going to get scores periodically in that basketball game. The JV game tonight went to Northfield over Rochester 49-39. The JV game here went to Northfield over Rochester 44-21. Thompson has it, gives top of the key to Eckert. Eckert, right side, 1-3-1 zone. Nope, that's going to be a 2-3 zone by Rochester, and the jumper off the glass goes to Lemming, and she puts Northfield Lady Norse on the board first at 2-0.
Advantage for Northfield with Lemming over Stasiak down low.
Yeah, right. Becky Malko inside the lane to Murph in the block. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line for two.
That's something Carly Murphy brings to the table for the Lady Beavers, her ability to drive down low and make something happen.
So Carly Murphy will go to the line to shoot two free throws for Rochester. Northfield up 2-0. 7:22 to play in the first quarter. Murph eyes the first one, lets it fly too hard off the back of the rim. She'll have one more. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Conference game tonight, non-conference Tuesday, conference on Wednesday, conference on Saturday for the Lady Zebras. That is all weather permitting, of course. Second one for Murph is good, and she gets the Lady Zebras on the board. It's 2-1 Northfield, and Thompson runs for the Lady Norse. Works it across the timeline. I see a triangle in two, Brad. I don't know what I see.
Yeah.
Baseline jumper on the way by Stefan is good. It looks like a triangle in two to me. Northfield up 4-1 regardless of the minute gone in the first quarter. Northfield in the man-to-man defense. Malco high on the right side. Picks up her dribble and travels.
I was leaning towards a man-to-man on the Lady Zebras.
Okay.
With Pollock playing the paint when the ball swings to the wings.
Well, Murphy is guarding Reed.
Yeah.
And it looks like X and – you're right, Brad. I think you're right. I think both – the ball's turned over. Both Stasiak and Pollock just kind of floating around in the paint. You're right. Murphy high on the left side. Rochester down by three. Murphy takes it to the baseline, throws him a shot. Good, the foul. Murphy will go to the line to shoot one.
Once again, Carly Murphy, using her ability to drive that lane, is able to get one off the glass and pick up the foul to go with it.
Obviously, Coach Stasiak saw something in his scouting to push Murph to do that here in this basketball game. It's 4-2. Rochester, Murph at the free throws, in and out, no good, and the rebound to Eckert.
Lemming picked up her second foul.
Really? Okay. Steven, left side, gives to Reed. Didn't he read? Against the defense, top of the key to Stefan. Stefan back to Reed. Looks down low to Eckert. Nice job by Stasiak. Fronting Eckert, can't get it through on the block.
Well, Pollock right behind, which kind of gives the passer a little bit to think about.
Lemming, cut off on the baseline by Pollock. Kicks it out to Eckert on the right wing, just inside the arc now. One dribble. Gives it out to Stefan. Make that to Thompson, and she has her pass knocked out of bounds by Malco. It'll stay on the far side to the Northfield Lady Norse. 6:08 to play, first quarter, 4-3 Northfield. Stefan, left wing to Reed. Reed looking down low, lobs it in to Eckert. Eckert on the block, down the paint. Gives to Stefan, make that Thompson. Thompson drives, throws up a shot at the glass, no good. Eckert's putback is good.
And that's where the Zebras got to do a better job of blocking out. Somebody's got to make sure they know where Eckert's at and keep a body on her.
I'm not real sure they weren't trying to block out there.
No.
Eckert's just that much longer than everybody else before.
Oh, you're right there.
6-3. Malcolm in the lane. Threads the needle. Pass down. Little B. Pollock. She puts it up and good. Rochester cuts the lead to one. B's first bucket of the night. Eckert. Back to Thompson. Now Reed crosses the timeline right behind the arc on the right wing. gives in the middle to Eckert. Her jump catches Herod, picked up by Stasiak. Malco now runs. Malco against Lemming. Layup is up and no good. Rebound to Stasiak. Her putback is no good. And Lemming with the rebound. She gives off to Thompson, who gives to Stephan. Wraparound pass to Eckert. Goes out of bounds, and it'll go back to Rochester. So 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Northfield by one. Rochester with an opportunity to take the lead for the first time in this game. After one, Northfield leads Rochester's guys 11-6. Again, that's after one at Rochester High School. 11-6, Northfield after one. Murph, Lehner, off the window. Nope. Stasiak, throw back. Good, the foul.
Nice job by Keith Stasiak right in position to make that rebound and get it back up quickly before the defense can react. And nice job by Carly Murphy once again taking the ball and pushing it towards the basket, realizing that the Cherish Lemming, who's guarding her, has two fouls
on
this game.
And that foul coming on Sydney Reed, the 5'9 senior. Stasiak at the line to shoot one, looking to put the Lady Zebras up by two. First one is a free throw. It's no good. Lemming at the board, gives to Reed. Sydney Reed, right side of the floor against Heck. Now brings it to the near side. Picks up a dribble over her head to Lemming on the right wing. Lemming, that looks at the three, just inside the arc. Set off. Her pass is a bad pass, and she stays it going, and I'm sorry, she does not save it going out of bounds. She grabs it while standing out of bounds, and it's going to go back to the Rochester Lady Zebras.
That's the fourth turnover by the Lady Norse.
They look rusty. They played last night. They look like the ones have been days off.
Of course, Rochester has yet to attempt a shot longer than about 3 feet from the basket.
I'm okay with that.
With the exception of free throws, which they haven't made. So
7-6, Rochester on top. 4:14 to play in the first quarter. Holland, top of the key to Murphy. Murphy resets between the rings against the man-to-man defense. Crossover dribble lane. Backs away in the paint. Wrap around pass to Pollock. B, jumper over the double team. No good. Lemming with the rebound for Northfield. Lemming gives off to Thompson. Now Lemming has it across the timeline. Now works left side to Eckert. Eckert back to Lemming. Layup off the glass is no good. In and out. Pollock with the rebound. Now to X. Rochester runs to our right. Up by one. Holland, behind her back dribble, gives up to Murph, top of the key. Three on the way over. Lemming is short. And the rebound to Northfield. And Stephan, left side of the floor. Works all the way inside the arc. Now gives to Eckert in the lane. Pull-up jumper from 10 feet is good. Wide open 10-footer, I might add.
Yeah. Pollock kind of backed off, thinking maybe she'd pass it down low to the block. And she didn't. She just pulled up, took that little 5-footer.
8-7 Northfield, 3:20 to play in the first quarter. High on the left side is Malco. Dribbles to the middle of the floor. Now through the center circle, works to the right wing. And she works against Thompson in the man-to-man defense. Now left side pass to Holland with 3:10 to play in the first quarter. Northfield by one. Bounce pass to Murphy at the free throw line. Murph studies, kicks it back out to X, high on the left side. X fakes the three, fakes it again, now drives. Between her legs dribble, and she is fouled going to the basket by Stephan on that far side. It'll be out of bounds to the Rochester Lady Zebras.
Stephan will pick up her first, team four. Murphy really wanted to drive off that free throw lane.
And she knows
she was looking past her, the lady guarding her, which is Lemming, and looking at Eckert standing 3 feet away. And
that's not a good matchup either.
She just couldn't convince herself she wanted to go.
Malcolm misses a shot in the lane. Holland with the rebound. X in the paint. Teardrop shot on the way is no good, but a foul coming to Northfield, and that's going to send Rochester to the line to shoot two.
And that's Reed's second.
Do you see the fouls? 5-0.
Yeah. And like you said, Northfield just played last night.
Yeah. Holland, first one, no good.
Wow. Rochester's now 2, 3, 4, 1 of 5.
In the first quarter.
Yes.
Northfield up 8-7. X with an opportunity to tie it. Eyes the second one. In and out, no good. Eckert to the board. Clears to Thompson. Thompson gives
so
the head. Lead.
What 10 days off does for you.
Yeah, you're right. Three in the way for Stephan is off the mark. No good. Eckert to the rebound. Eckert dribbles out of trouble. Picks up her dribble to baseline. Now outside to Reed. Reed sets the middle of the floor, works right wing. Almost has her pocket picked by X. Now gives it Thompson. Her jumper over Stasiak is no good. Ball tipped around. Comes down to Lemming. Lemming kicks it out to Stephan. Now near side to Thompson. Thompson with a foot on the line. Takes a long jumper. No good. And the rebound to Lemming. Lemming, her jumper from 10 feet, no good. And Pollock finally grabs the board and gives it to Stasiak. Keaton runs middle of the floor, right through the center circle. Now gives high on the left side to Murphy. 2 minutes of play, first quarter. And now Stasiak runs the point. I don't think I've seen this all year.
No, this is something new.
Stasiak outside to Malco. Fakes the three at the elbow. Kicks it out to Stasiak. Keaton now at the free throw line. Cut off by the defense. Down low to Murphy. Murphy shover. Good foul. Livingston picked up foul number three.
That's why they were doing that. Coach Stasiak wanted to get Murphy down low one-on-one against Fleming, and it worked.
Murphy will go to the line to shoot one free throw with her Lady Zebras now up 9-8 with a minute 50 to play in the first quarter. And I got to believe Northfield's got to go to their bench, and they will. And they'll send Jacqueline Thies in, a 5'5 freshman who played a lot of minutes in that JV game. As Murph hits the free throw, puts the Rochester Lady Zebras up by two. And Thies into the game for the first time. And, Brad, probably Lemming will be on the bench for a while.
I'm guessing, yeah, second, third quarters, my guess.
Minute 50 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 10-8 here at Northfield High School. Steffen through the center circle against X. Loses her dribble, now picks it up at the volleyball line to Thompson, to Pease. Long jumpers off the mark, no good. And then we're going to have an offensive rebound on Steffen, and X is going to pick up the foul.
The first foul on Rochester.
The Rochester guys at home with Northfield tonight. And after one, Northfield Northfield was leading Rochester 11-6. Thompson looks to get it in. Over the top of the defense to Eckert. Eckert against Malco. Back to Steffen, make that Thompson, and jumper's no good. And we got a rebound to Pease, and I believe Pease is going to be fouled on the drive by Pollock.
Yep, timing is off. You can tell B. Pollock had position for that rebound, and she just jumped when the ball hit the rim instead of waiting for it to come off the rim. Ball went behind her.
Thompson looks to get it in, baseline right for Northfield. Eckert at the free throw line. In the paint, pull up 10-footer on the way, too hard, and the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton gives off to Murphy. Rochester runs to our right, up by two. Minute 20 to play, first quarter. Murphy on the right side against Reed. Takes her to the free throw line. Now pulls it back outside. Now in the paint for Rochester. Out to X. Three on the way. Left wing for the Lady Zebras is off the mark. No good. And the rebound to Thompson. Thompson runs for Northfield. A minute to play in the first quarter to Eckert. Eckert, a foot inside the three-point line, gives to Reed. Her layup is on the way off the glass. No good. Malco with the rebound and runs. Becky Malco running to our right, right side of the floor, accelerates around the defense, pull up by her is good.
Malco just went to another gear and left the Northfield defense standing.
Holland steals the basketball. Her shot is blocked by Eckert, and she brings it up the floor to Eckert. Now left side to Steffen. 12-8 Rochester, 40 seconds to play in the first quarter to Pease. Pease, left side to Reed. Reed looking down low to Eckert. Keaton Stasiak doing a fantastic job on Eckert, giving up about 8 inches.
Yeah, and she knows she's got Pollock behind her to help out.
Reed, layup through the lane is good. 12-10, Rochester. 20 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester will look for the final shot of the period.
Reed right now playing with two fouls. She's guarding Murphy.
15 seconds to play, first quarter. Malco with the basketball, works to the right side. Man-to-man defense by Northfield. 9 seconds, 8 seconds, 7. X has it with 5, and now we're going to have a foul on, that's going to be Steffen, who ran through the screen of Keaton Stasiak.
That's her second foul.
And now Rochester will shoot free throws for the rest of the half.
Northfield in foul trouble with Reed and Steffen, both with 2. Lemming already on the bench with 3.
Wow. At the free throw line is Keaton Stasiak for 1 of the bonus. First on the way for the sophomores. Good, she'll have 1 more. And Bailey Abbott will come into the game for the first time for Rochester, and Abbott will replace Carly Murphy. 5.7 to play, first quarter. Rochester by 3. Stasiak with 1 more for the Lady Zebras. Eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's in and out, no good. Eckert to the rebound. And her pass was picked off. Thompson has it with 1. Thompson's not going to get a shot off at the buzzer. After 1, Rochester leads 13-10 on the road. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
Start of the second quarter, the Lady Zebras will start with the basketball, and Brad, another JV kid, Abby Kiefaber, comes into the game because Northfield in serious foul trouble.
They are. Lemming with three, Reed and Stephan both with two.
We've got a kick on a pass by Northfield. It's going to stay out of bounds to Rochester. Begin as we close the first quarter break. Northfield picked up their 17th foul, so Rochester will shoot free throws from here on out. Holland looks to get it in. Next, Studies. Gives to Pollock. Pollock down low over Kiefaber. Jumper good off the glass. 15-10 Rochester. 7:40 to play in the first half. Here comes the half-court trap by the Lady Zebras. Stephan across to Pease. Back to Stephan. Now to Thompson. Right side to Kiefaber. Long three is short. And the rebound to Pollock. And she rips it away from Northfield. And now gives to Malco. Rochester up by five.
Great effort by P. Pollock to get in there and fight the double team to get the rebound.
Keaton Stasiak, her wraparound pass down low to Pollock. It's tipped away, and Northfield cannot save it from going out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester. Nice job by Stephan, who just about swiped that pass by Bailey Abbott.
She had it timed pretty well. The pass came in low on a bounce pass. She picked it up off the bounce.
Yep.
Just couldn't keep herself in bounds.
Holland lobs it into B. Pollock. In the lane, leaner off the window, good again. And now Rochester, biggest team on the floor, is making them Northfield pay for that a little bit. With a minute gone in the second quarter, Rochester now by seven. Kiefaber, down low to Pease. Pease layup on the window is good. 17-12, Rochester by five. And X crossed it across the timeline, high on the right side. Crossover dribble, top of the key to Malco. Murphy still on the bench for the Lady Zebras. Malcolm, law pass down low to Murphy. Her jumper's good again.
Pollock. That's her eighth point and six. She scored the last three baskets.
Yeah, I was going to say three consecutive trips down the floor went to B's. 19-12, Rochester on top. Eckerd goes to the basket hard. She throws up a shot too hard. Over the back, rebound over Pollock. Gives off.
Blocked by Malcolm.
Yep. Thompson's shot was blocked by Malco. Now Kiefaber holds top of the key for the Lady Norris. Now to P. She'll fire a three right wing. It's short. Draws nothing but air out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester up by seven. 6:06 to play, first half. Rochester up 19-12. And they'll have the basketball going to our right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Charlie Murphy will come in at the next opportunity. Malco works to the right wing, picks up a dribble, lobs down low. And this time Eckerd intercepts it. Eckerd now pulls up, almost loses it, off to Pease. Pease, jumper from 10 feet is short, and the rebound to Abbott, who gives to Stasiak. Rochester runs through the center circle. Keaton, outside to X, fakes a three, and she travels. So Murphy back into the game, and coming out will be Keaton Stasiak with 5:40 to play in the first half. Rochester up 19-12, and Sydney Reed will come back into the game for Northfield, playing with two personal fouls, and replace Stephan.
Well, Stasiak hasn't gotten a lot of rebounds tonight. She hasn't scored a lot of points tonight, but she's done a heck of a job playing defense against Eckerd.
And running the point, which we haven't seen all year.
Eckerd's only got 4 points so far in the ballgame.
Fantastic. Right side, Kiefaber, long three for Northfield, short again. Rebound offensively again. Pease put back is good. And Coach Stasiak now just stands on the sideline, arm crossed, and said, we have got to get a body on somebody and quit giving up offensive boards. Murphy on the left wing, makes the drive, pulls it out, resets for Rochester, 5:10 to play first half, Rochester by five. Murph goes to the baseline, looks to get rid of it now, nice defense by Northfield, out to Malco with her feet on the line, long jumper is short, or too long, and Abbott with the rebound, now to Murph, high on the left side, under five to play first half.
Great job by Bailey Abbott, got herself in position for the long rebound, pulled it down.
Murph picks her way through traffic in the lane, and she is fouled on the shot, she'll go to the line for two.
Carly Murphy doing a really good job of getting some dribble drive down into traffic. And when she gets down in there, she puts up some kind of a shot. And for the most part, she's getting fouled every time.
At halftime, Rochester leads Northfield now 12-11 at Rochester High School. Merce first free throw short. Now, remember, the score after one, Northfield 11, Rochester 6. Rochester held Northfield without a bucket in that second quarter. In fact, Northfield had a possession that lasted 2 minutes and 11 seconds that ended in a travel. That's from Val Saris, the Rochester Sentinel.
That'll make a coach pull his hair out.
Second one for Murph is good this time. 20-14, Rochester by 6, 4:50 to play in the first half. Reed, a long pass ahead to Kiefaber against Abbott. Kiefaber, one dribble, back to Reed. Sydney Reed now middle of the floor and has her pass picked off by Malco. Malco will go in for the right-handed layup. It's good. Rochester up 22-14. Timeout Northfield at the 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Welcome back to Northfield High School. 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester up by 8 at 22-14. Again, last report at Rochester, where the Rochester guys are playing Northfield tonight. The Zebras lead 12-11 at recess. 12-11 at recess. So after Northfield timeout, they'll have the basketball. They need to go the length of the floor. Brad Thomas on David Musselman. And like Tony has said, basically the entire year, especially after their first loss in the conference, they're playing for their conference life right now,
and
this game and every game.
You're right, and they are. Witco and Wabash play tomorrow night at Wabash, and that's another key conference game.
Yeah, I don't know if anybody anticipated Witco only losing one to this point. Murphy, there's been a shot foul on the shot. She's going to line for two. Is that going to be on Reed?
Oh, sure boy, is. That's her third.
Oh, baby.
So now Reed and Lemming both with three as Holland goes to the free throw line.
And Stephen will come back into the game after the first free throw by Alexa Holland, who eyes the first one and lets it go. It's good as it rolls over the front of the rim. So Stephen back into the game for Northfield, and Sydney Reed with three personal fouls will sit right beside Lemming, who also has three personal fouls.
Katie Stephen with two is on the floor yet for Northfield.
X with one more looking to push this to a 10-point lead. Second one is good again, and it's 24-14, Rochester. And ahead is Stephen. Stephen across the timeline. Now left side to Kiefaber. She loses it, picks it up. Now the middle of the floor to Thomas. She'll take the long three. It's good. Thompson, he's got a two. Thompson hits a two, and it's 24-16. Holland. High in the middle of the floor, I guess, to Murphy at the volleyball line. Where she gets Peckard, crossover dribble, backs her way into the paint, goes to the basket. There's a shot, it's good. Murphy with two more in traffic. And Rochester back by 10 with 3:40 to play in the first half.
Murphy now with nine. Wide open Eckard underneath.
How do you miss Eckard? 6 foot Eckard got behind the defense and put it in for a wide open layup. 3.5 to play first half. Rochester up 26-18. And now Rochester basketball going to our right. Murph works on the right wing.
Stasiak trying to post down low.
Good job by Dees.
Yeah.
Murph on the block. Throws up a prayer. No.
Murphy trying to draw the foul. Couldn't get it.
Kiefaber gives to Thompson. Quickly ahead to Pease. Pease inside the three-point line. Backs away in. Has the ball tipped away from behind but picked up by Eckard. Now to Stephen. Quickly to Kiefaber. Kiefaber right side to Thompson on the right baseline. Now to Kiefaber on the wing. Kiefaber on the right wing. Back to Thompson between the ring. Now left side to Stephen with under three to play in the first half. Rochester by eight. Right side to Kiefaber. 18-footer short. And the long rebound comes down to Murphy, who gives to Holland. Rochester runs to our right up by eight. Holland, left side of the floor, drives to the baseline, throws up a teardrop shot, no good. Rebound to Pease, and Stasiak's going to be called for over the back.
Yeah, I think Holland needs to take a little better shot than that, just kind of running off the baseline and throwing it towards the basket instead of taking a shot.
Here is why Northfield is as close as they are right now. They've got their two stars on the bench with three fouls.
Mm-hmm.
I have been really impressed with Pease and Kiefaber off the bench, who is able to keep this game close.
I would agree with that, along with Rochester's missed opportunity at the free throw.
You're right. Pease is fouled. going to the basket by Bailey Abbott. Yep, and the B. Pollock will come back into the game for Rochester. 2:29 to play, first half. Rochester up 26-18. And Alexa Garrison will make her Northfield debut. And she'll come into the game. Bailey Abbott comes out. Also coming out will be Carly Murphy. Thompson will look to get it in. Does so to Ecker behind the three-point line. Now quickly to Murphy, top of the key. Dump pass down low to Eckerd. Eckerd loses the basketball, and Thompson has it standing out of bounds.
Great job by Holland sneaking in behind Eckerd. Tipped it away, and I think it was Keyes that tried to save it and couldn't.
So Rochester has it. Going to our right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Malka behind the arc, left side. Down low to Garrison. Her jumper's no good, and we're going to have a tie-up, and Northfield going to get it back. So Northfield going to get it back after tying up Garrison on the down low. Northfield to get it back going to our right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Pull-up jumper for Keyfaber is high arcing shot, no good, and the basketball goes out of bounds with Malco Lang on it.
And they're going to call Malco out of bounds.
Yeah.
So
she might got a little hip check.
I'm thinking, yeah.
Baseline left is Thompson. She'll look to trigger it in around Malco. Bounce pass to Keyfaber in the left baseline. Keyfaber holds. Her pass is thrown away, picked up by Holland. And she saved it from going out of bounds. Fortunately, right in the hands of Stasiak, who gives to Malco. Malco drives up to Stasiak on the baseline. Now back to the ring, wing. Stasiak now in the paint. Stops. Loses the handle. Ball tipped around. Stefan has it. Stefan against X. And then X almost picks the pocket. Now does. X then to Pollock. Now to Malco to Stasiak. To Malco on the baseline. Malco's jumper is off the window and good. Rochester by 10.
And quickly, Northfield back up the floor. Fields, Keyes, a shot off the backboard, and she's fouled. So she'll go to the line to shoot two. And the foul for Rochester is coming against Holland. That's her second.
Minute 13 to play in the first half. Rochester up 28-18. And at the free throw line will be Jacqueline Pease, a 5'5 freshman, to shoot two for her Lady Norse. Pease eyes her first one. Let's it go, and good. Murphy back into the game.
Keyes has got 5 points coming off the bench here in the second quarter for Northfield.
A much-needed 5 points with three personal fouls.
She leads Northfield in scoring right now.
Yeah. Keyes ready for her second one.
Eckert's got six.
The second one is in and out, no good. Stasiak to the board, gives to Murphy. 28-19 Rochester. 70 seconds to play first half. Murph in the paint, pulls up, jumper off the glass, good. You just don't see that. When you're in the middle of the floor, you don't see the backboard used that often, and Murphy did that time. Good for her.
Well, it's not often that nobody picks Murphy up.
Yeah, right. Pass is lost out of bounds. Nope. Safe from going out of bounds by Thompson, and then she bangs it off the leg of Holland out of bounds. It'll stay with Northfield on the far side.
Murphy now with 11.
11 of the 30. 30-19 Rochester. Pease between the rings. Bounce pass left side to Thompson, who's cutting through the lane. And she's going to be fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Who's that going to be whistled against? I think she just lost it out of bounds.
I thought she did too. Lost it going up.
Going to be whistled against Keaton.
Stasiak will pick up her second.
46 seconds to play first half. 30-19 Rochester. And at the free throw line is Peyton Thompson, a 5'5 sophomore for the Lady Norse. First one's up and good. So I have one more. Looking to cut just inside double digits. One more coming for Thompson. Eyes a second one. Lets it fly. Good again. 30-21 Rochester. 40 seconds to play in the first half. Malco across the timeline. Man-to-man defense by the Lady Norse. Works to the left side of the elbow. Now out to Murph high on the left side. Murph against Eckert. Holds with 30. Murphy holds with 29.
More importantly for Rochester, whether or not they score, is that they don't allow Northfield to get another
bucket. Exactly. Murphy against Eckert with 20. Dribble pass to Holland with 18. Now to Malco with 16. Around the defense with 15. Back to Holland with 13. Back to Malco with 12. Malco right side against the double team with 10, and she is fouled about 25 feet away from the basket by, I believe, Thompson, which is going to send Rochester to the line, I think, for two free throws.
That is Thompson's first.
So two free throws coming for the Lady Zebras, looking to push this lead back to double digits, 9.5 to play in the first half. Malco there to shoot two. Becky eyes the first one, lets it fly, and good as it bounces high off the back of the rim and in. And Garrison and Abbott back in. Holland and Stasiak will sit. Rochester by 10 with 9.5 seconds to play in the first half. Malco ready for her second one. The biggest lead of the night has been 11 for Rochester. Eyes the second one. Lets it fly. No good. Too hard. Pollock with the rebound. With Eckert guarding, out to Malco with 5. Right side to Murphy with 4. Murphy with 3. Drives in the baseline. Throws up a shot. She travels with .3.
Probably should have shot it when she caught it.
Yep.
There wasn't anything down low. She tried to drive and create something and ran out of floor.
So Northfield baseball pass down the lake. Eckert catches and cannot get a shot off. At halftime, Rochester leads 31-21. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
So at the third quarter, Rochester start with the basketball going to our left as Murphy will trigger it in to Malco. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. I, too, obviously, picking the Broncos. And then I hope Manning retires.
I don't. Let him come back.
Lob pass to Pollock. B over the defense. Shot no good. Ball being tipped around. Loose on the floor. We're going to have a tie-up. Nope. Lemmy comes out of there with it and gives to Reed. Reed runs it up the floor, and she travels. Oh, I was going to say, how did she get away with that? But she did not.
Nice job by Holland and Malco.
Forcing
it down.
Yeah,
and Holland did a great job of getting it, not running on the hip, but actually getting down floor in front of her and causing her to pick that ball up.
Malco, top of the key, works to the left wing. Cut off and taken away now is Reed, and then she has to strip from behind. And now we're going to have a foul on Sydney Reed on the push. And that's going to be foul number 4 on Reed.
Yeah. So Holland, a great job of tipping the ball away when she went to go retrieve it. Reed reaching out, in an attempt to try and save the ball.
I think
catching
Coach
Holland on the ankle.
I think Coach Jeff Thalman had a legitimate beef with
right.
that call.
I think both girls were trying to go for the loose ball.
So Pease back into the game for Northfield. Rochester up by 10 with 30 seconds gone in the third quarter here in Northfield High School. Again, after three, the guys playing Northfield tonight tied at 21. Holland in the paint. Holland steps back behind the three-point line out of Murphy between the rings. Murphy against Eckert, takes her to the elbow, cut off up top. Now to Holland, three straight away, off the mark, no good, rebound to Lemming.
And that's the answer for Murphy's 11 first-half points, as she now has Eckert guarding her.
Yeah, right. Pease gives to Eckert, top of the key. Now swings right side to Pease. Pease, one dribble to Lemming in the paint. Cut off, jumper on the way is good. Lemming, nice leaner on the way, nice leaner by the junior, and cuts the lead to 8. 6:40 to play, third quarter, Rochester by 8. Murphy down low to Pollock. Pollock jump on the baseline is good. We're back to 10. 6.5 to play. Full court press by the Lady Zebras. Steffen will bring it up the floor against Holland. Backs away across the timeline. Down to Eckert. Eckert pull up jumper over Stasiak's. No good. Offensive rebound to Thompson as she found on the putback. Sugar to the line to shoot two.
Pollock's going to pick up her second.
So going to the line is Thompson. So Thompson to the line for two. Eyes the first one on the way is good. She's darn near automatic into this basketball game from the stripe.
So far she's perfect.
6:17 to play, third quarter. Rochester up 33-24. Thompson for Northfield at the free throw line for one more. The sophomore eyes the second one and it goes in again. 8-point lead for the Zebras. 6:10 to play, third quarter. Malco across the timeline left, works against Thompson. High on the right side to Holland. Holland back to Malco on the near side. Rochester has attempted some threes, has not hit any in this game, and Keaton Stasiak travels going to the basket.
Yeah, I think one attempted three by Holland and one attempted three by Murphy, and I don't remember any others.
Yeah, I don't think, and obviously none of them have been knocked down.
No.
Everything's
been down low, Murphy and Pollock.
He's down low to Eckert, layup is good. Northfield broke that press easily and has set the lead to 6. Holland high on the right side for Rochester, top to Murphy. Murph between the rings, a couple of dribbles to the right side, looking down low to Pollock, can't find her. Picks up her dribble, now to Stasiak. Keaton with the basketball to Holland. I make that to Malco, drives it out to X on the left side. And then she throws it away into the hands of Eckert, gives the head to Thompson. Thompson then is fouled going to the basket by Malco, and it'll be out of bounds in Northfield, baseline left.
Well, as sharp as Rochester was in the first half, I think they went to halftime and took a nap.
Yeah,
because they not woke up here in the third quarter. They just seem unsure of what they're doing.
Bailey Abbott comes back into the game for Rochester, and Holland will sit down. Baseline left are the Northfield Lady Norse. And Thompson will look to trigger it in. Thompson to Lemming. Ten-footer's good. Man. And this is the first girl off the bench because of a injury to one of their starters. She's playing really well tonight when she's been in the game. She's been collared with three fouls, though. Northfield has really turned up their defensive pressure.
Yeah, they have.
Stasiak now runs the point for Rochester.
And they've switched up their defensive effort, too. No longer is Eckert playing in the paint. She's staying on Murphy.
Ball loose. Murphy picks it up. Gives to Malco. Malco ahead to Abbott. Left hand to layup on the way out. The glass is good. Timeout. Coach Stasiak and the Lady Zebras at the 30. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
To play in the third quarter. Rochester leading 35-29 and Northfield with the basketball going to our right. With 5 minutes to play at Rochester, Northfield now up 28-21. Oh, Steffen just about travels over to back home there.
Yep.
And then throws it behind the timeline. And a turnover Northfield, and Rochester going to get the basketball back. Up only by 6 now with 4:45 to play in the third. the youngsters the difference of this game.
You're right.
Northfield.
For Northfield, yep, coming off the bench, bailing them out.
And now Lemming back on the floor, putting some big buckets in from about 10 feet out. Basiak on the baseline, out to Malco, fakes a three, takes it to the paint, out to Murphy. Murphy against Eckert, stands behind the three-point line right side, backs away in the paint, loses the basketball, now to Stasiak. Keaton wraparound pass to Pollock, on the baseline is B, loses the handle, out to Stasiak. Keaton drives, her wraparound pass to Malco, three, top of the key, short, and the rebound to Lemming. And now Lemming is fouled hard by Murphy or Pollock.
This is what they're called on. That's Pollock's third.
4:13, and the wheel's kind of coming off here a little bit for the Lady Zebras.
Well, Northfield's trying to they're pressing. They're offensively and defensively, they're striking up the tempo, and Rochester's having trouble getting started after the half.
Lemming drives to the baseline. Out down low to Thompson. Back to Lemming in the paint. Throws him a shot over Pollock on the glass, and good. Northfield within four. 3:50 to play in the third. Murphy through the center circle against Eckert. Takes the right side. Outside to Malco. She'll fire another long three. It's short again. And the rebound to Malco. Outside to Murphy. Murphy backs away in the paint. And her pass wrapped around. It's down to Pollock. But before the pass, we're going to have a foul on Eckert. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester. Baseline left as Holland will come back into the game for the Lady Zebras.
Eckert will pick up her first.
Somebody's going to take it out, right?
They're going to leave. Pollock in with three.
And Murphy comes out. Holland, baseline left, will look to get it in. Holland studies. Gets it in to Stasiak. Now to Holland left baseline. One dribble to Stasiak on the wing. Looking down low to B. Good defense by Eckert. To Holland. Holland studies. One dribble top of the key to Malco with 3.5 to play in the third. Malco steps back to the volleyball line. Now between the rings. Now drives it right. Bounce pass to Holland behind the arc on the right side. Law pass to Pollock. Loses it. Out, Abbott there to get it. Now Stasiak, top to Malco, to X for three, short, rebound to Stasiak, out to Holland, and makes that to Malco. Got a B off her foot, picked up by Steffen. Dorfield runs to our right, and her pass is picked off by Malco, who saves it in the hands of Holland. Rochester runs to our left now. Under three to play in the third quarter, Rochester by four. Right side is Malco. Makes the three, couple of dribbles. Baseline to Stasiak. Keaton in the paint. Rises up. Fouling the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. One thing Rochester likes to do is hit them from behind the arc, and they are not falling tonight.
You're right. That's Lemming's fourth now for Northfield.
And now Lemming and Reed, right?
You're right. But more importantly, Lemming had 6 points out for eight in that third quarter.
Stasiak misses the free throw bad. She'll have one more as Murphy comes back into the game and Pollock sit. Lemming comes out with four.
So Lemming, a big key to Northfield cutting this lead back down to four.
I agree with that. Stasiak with one more, looking to push this lead to five for the Lady Zebras with 2:49 to play in the third. Keaton eyes the second one, lets her fly. No good again. And a long rebound to Eckert. Now to Thompson, ahead now to Kiefaber, who's back in the game for Lemming. Kiefaber, a couple of dribbles. Eckert, top of the key. Eckert drives it against Abbott. Out to Kiefaber. A couple of dribbles to Thompson. Quick jumper from the free throw line goes out of bounds, and it'll go back to Rochester. 2.5 to play in the third. Rochester by four. At last report, the Rochester guys trailing Northfield late in that basketball game, 28-21.
The Lady Zebras have been outscored 10-4 in this quarter.
Mm-hmm. And like you say, six of those from Lemming.
Yeah.
Malco works right side, gets a pick from Stasiak. Picks up a dribble down low to Stasiak. Keaton jumper off the window and good. Nice pick and roll by the Lady Zebras. 6-point lead now for Rochester. Thompson quickly up the floor, gives right side to Kiefaber. Kiefaber loses the handle. She gets it back off of the hands of Abbott. Wrap around pass to Steffen. Off the glass is good. A helter-skelter play that time turns into a bucket for Northfield, who cuts the lead again to four. Holland steps back behind the arc, gives it to Murphy in the middle of the floor against Eckert.
2-3 zone almost, it looks like, by Northfield, but it's a sagging man-to-man.
Malco to Murph, left wing, 1:50 to play in the third. Murphy fakes, drives, paint, jumper block. Abbott loses it out of bounds. Oh, they're going to say last set by Northfield.
Yeah, and it was.
And it'll stay with Rochester baseline left, 1:44 to play in the third. Rochester by four.
Coach Stasiak wanting Murphy to take that ball against Eckert and see if she could draw the foul. He thought heat she had on that last attempt that could get called.
Yeah, she swatted that one pretty easily.
Yeah.
Stasiak is fouled of a shot. She'll go back to the lane to shoot two, with Rochester up 37-33 with a minute 42 to play in the third quarter. Brad
Jacqueline.
Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Jacqueline Pease picking up her first.
Okay. Stasiak with two. Keaton. Eyes the first one, lets it fly. That good as it rolls around the rim and falls through. One more coming for the sophomore. Looking to push this lead back to six. Rochester's biggest lead of the night has been 11, coming late in the second quarter. Stasiak eyes the second one, lets it fly. No good off the side of the rim. Eckert with a rebound. Northfield run. Eckert now gives off to Thompson through the center circle. Is Thompson, now right side to Kiefaber. Gives to Eckert to the elbow.
Nice job by Abbott as she's able to step inside and tip that basketball away on the pass to Eckert. And it's a good thing because Pease was wide open on the opposite block. Had Eckert been able to catch it and turn, it would have been an easy bucket for Northfield.
5-point lead for Rochester as the third quarter comes to a close. We're a minute 20 to play in the third. Murphy high on the right side. Murphy against Eckert. Wrap around pass to Holland on the right left wing. Holland dribbles at the free throw line in the paint outside to Murph. Murph studies against Eckert to the 110 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 38-33. Murphy works left wing. Murphy gets hit in the mouth. Throws up a shot of the glass. No good. Rebound to Pease.
She got fouled two or three times on that drive. No
Pease
call.
Pushes for Northfield against Holland with 58 seconds. Now top to Kiefaber, right side to Thompson. 50 seconds. Play third quarter to Steffen. To Kiefaber behind the arc left side. Now to Pease just inside the arc. She drives. Throws up a 15-footer. No good. Stasiak with the rebound and run. Stasiak with 40 seconds. Left side of the floor. Pulls up. Now gives to Murph. Rochester up 38-33. 35 seconds to play in the third quarter. Murphy between the rings against Eckert in the man-to-man defense. Backs away to the timeline. We're down under 30 seconds to play in the third. Rochester by five. Around Eckert. Down low. Throws up a shot. No good.
Wow. Wait, Eckert guard. Just linebacker plowed her way through a pick. No call.
And then Bailey Abbott just got away with a foul.
Yep. She was waiting for the whistle. It never come. Northfield coach going crazy, but the referee's not calling it from either side.
And then they're going to say it was knocked out of bounds by Northfield.
Rochester call.
Wow. 10 seconds of play in the third. Rochester by five. Malco, high on the right side, holds with seven. To X with five. X drives with four. Pulls it out. Now at the free throw line with three. X with two. Throws him a prayer. No good at the buzzer. After three, Rochester up 38-33. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community. Family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Back at Northfield High School for the final quarter, the Rochester Lady Zebras somehow clinging to a 5-point lead where that second, third quarter was all Northfield.
Yeah, it was. And I don't think they're going away tonight.
No, that's right. I think they might have learned a lesson.
Yeah, senior night, these girls are going to compete all the way to the end. Rochester, they need to play smarter. I think they've got the ability to run away with this basketball game. But
yeah.
They're not playing very smart.
You're right. There's been some questionable shots, shot selections, and questionable passing.
Yeah.
Rochester now in a 1-3-1 zone to start the fourth quarter. Reed and Lemming. Nope, Lemming not back in the game. Thompson, a long three, is short. And the rebound to Stasiak, who gives to Malco. So Malco runs for Rochester. Middle of the floor against Thompson. Works the left side, now in the paint. Kicks it out to Holland. Rochester has not hit a three tonight. They've attempted a few, but nothing going down.
Well, the third quarter demonstrated that Northfield's going to play with a chip on their shoulder. Rochester's going to have to equal that intensity.
Habit shot no good. Pollock's putback is good. They went right at Sydney Reed, looking to get her to foul out. No call on the shot. And Rochester back by seven with 35 seconds gone in the fourth.
I don't think there's been much calls made in the second half period.
Yeah, I agree. Key favor, high on the left side. Steffen to Thompson. Thompson, oh, gets away with a double dribble. Now right side to Steffen. Now see a free throw line to Reed. Cutting to Kiefaber. Wraparound pass is knocked away, but Malco going to pick up a foul, and it'll be out of bounds to Northfield with 6:54 to play in the game.
Malco's second. Yeah, both teams, well, we had roughly 20 fouls in the first half. Seven total here.
Yeah, right. Thompson baseline right for Northfield. Rochester by seven. Thompson looking. Got to get it in around Malco. Thompson over the top of the defense to Eckert, who stands right in front of the Northfield bench. Now to Steffen, top of the key. Now to Kiefaber, left side to Thompson. Another long three for Northfield. Good this time. And the lead is back to four for Rochester after a three-point bomb by Northfield Thompson, 40-36. Holland, between her legs dribble. And she is fouled on the reach-in by Steffen. That'll be out of bounds to Rochester right in front of the Northfield student body.
That'll be her third.
She had two in the first half, so she played a really clean game. Has Steffen in this second half.
Yes.
Six and a half to play in the game. Rochester by four at 40-36. Malco will set up shot between the rings for the Lady Zebras. In the paint, pass down Lita Pollock. Loses it through her hands. They're going to say last touch by Rochester, and they'll go back to Northfield. Not a bad pass, kind of low. B had a hard time grabbing that one. Steffen, I make that Thompson across the timeline through the center circle. Left side to Reed, who's been awfully quiet in this basketball game. I'm not sure how many points she has. The key paper to Eckert, layup. Nope! Her putback is good. And now the lead to Rochester's cut to two. Rochester runs, top of the key, 40-38, Lady Zebras. Holland dribbles to the right wing. Now Malco in the center circle. Holds with under six to play in the game. Malco works against Thompson. Dribbles out to Ett. Three on the way. Short. Rebound to P. Pollock. And Eckert just come over the back. And now Rochester will be shooting free throws from here on out.
Eckert picks up her second. Coach Stasiak thinking, finally, we got that call. He's been looking for that call since the first quarter.
Yeah. So Eckert has two. Back into the game is Lemming with four. And Keith able to come out. 5:45 to play in the game. Rochester up 40-38. Holland gets it to Stasiak. Keaton against Fleming. Picks up her dribble. Now bounce pass to Holland. They're going to lose it out of bounds. And then last touch by Steffen on the far side. Murphy back into the game for Rochester. Abbott to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 5:38 to play in the game. Rochester up 40-38. They had an 11-point lead in the second quarter, and watch that dissolve in third.
Abbott once again giving the Rochester Lady Zebras good minutes off the bench.
Right. Murphy against Eckert. Kicks it out to Malco for three left wing. Good! Rochester back up now by 43-38 count. Now Lemming has it on the wing. Lemming in the paint. The Reed. Reed drives it. Cut off by the defense. Out to Thompson. Thompson at the elbow. Goes to the glass. Layup. Good! The foul! Is that going to be Pollock or is that going to be Malco?
It's Malco.
So going to the free throw line is Thompson, looking to cut this Rochester lead to two again with 5:13 to play in the game. Sophomore's free throw is good. She is perfect from the line.
5 for 5 from the line. She's got 11.
43-41 Rochester. 5 minutes to play in the game. Murphy loses the handle. Out of bounds, they're going to say last touch by Murphy on the shirt. It's going to go back to Northfield. Another questionable shot by the Lady Zebras.
Yeah.
Rochester in a full court press. Thompson has it. She'll bring it up the floor. On a jog to the center circle, right side to Reed. Reed to a cutting Lemming, right-handed layup. It's good, it was tied. 43-43. Rochester the basketball. They have not trailed since about 6-5. Falco top, long three. Yep. Rochester back up by three. Full court press on the Lady Zebras. Thompson ahead to Eckerd. Eckerd goes to the basket against Pollock. Through her shot, no good. Ball tipped around. Rochester comes out of there with it. Stasiak, right side of the floor, now pulls up and gives off to a guard. And Murphy has it with 3:15. I'm sorry, 4:15 to play in the game. Rochester by three. Murphy against Eckerd. Gets a pick from Pollock. Top two, Stasiak. Keaton drives it. Goes to the basket. Left handed layup. Good. 48-43. Rochester by five. 4 minutes to play in the game. Steffen to Reed from the free throw line. Jumper is good off the front of the rim. And Rochester, with the basketball inbound, is going to get, Northfield with Rochester the ball inbound, get the timeout, get the 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
Back at Northfield High School, Rochester leading 48-45. They've got the basketball going to our left with 3:40 to play in the game. Stasiak against Reed. Loses the handle, tied up. Rochester's going to keep possession. So it'll stay with Rochester on the near side, right in front of the Rochester bench. With 3.5 to play in the game, Rochester at 48-45. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Holland will look to get triggered in. DeMalco through the center circle, works against Thompson. Works to the right side, behind her back dribble, in the paint, wrap around past the Pollock, layup's good. Rochester up by five at 50-45, full court press by the Lady Zebras. Thompson, baseball pass ahead to Lemming. Lemming gives to Steffen, who pulls it back outside and resets for Northfield, and then has her pocket picked by Holland. Hex with the basketball, stops, and is fouled going to the basket by Steffen, and Holland will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Steffen will pick up her four. So Lemming, Reed, and Steffen all with four.
3:06 to play in the game. Rochester by five at 50-45. And Holland at the line to shoot one and the bonus for her Lady Zebras. Free throw shooting has been horrid in the first half for sure. Holland's first one's good. Pushes the lead back to six with 3:06 to play in the game. And did Coach Stasiak just call for a triangle and two? Watch. Second one by Holland. Good again. 52-45. 3 minutes to play in the game. Steffen across the timeline to Lemming. Lemming cut off by the defense. Now to Reed at the elbow. Reed almost has the basketball stolen. Now to Steffen. Three on the way for Northfield. Short. Rebound to Malco. Rochester runs up 52-45. And now this is about the time that Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
To play in the game. Rochester up 52-45. And after the Lady Zebra timeout, we'll have it right in front of the scores table going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. And what I was getting ready to say is this is about the time of game where Rochester likes to run some clock.
Yeah, I don't know if I would like that idea right now. I think you stay engaged.
Put on the gas.
Yep, you stay engaged. This Northfield team is fired up. They're looking to try and run as much as they can.
Murphy gets Eckerd, takes her left side. Now to Malco with 2.5. Malco in the paint. Loses the handle. Stolen by Steffen. And then she is fouled hard by Holland.
Holland picks up her third. Holland and Malco and Pollock all with three for Rochester.
2:26 to play in the game. Rochester up 52-45. Northfield of the basketball going to our right. Steffen gets it into Thompson. Thompson kicks it back out to Steffen. Now right side to Eckert. Eckert in the paint to Lemming. 10-footer right side. No good. Rebound to Holland. 2:15 to play in the game. Rochester up by 7.
Now he's spreading it out. He's going to run the clock.
We've seen this all season long. Whether they're up by 10 or 20 or 5, this is exactly what they do.
Problem is when you're only 10 of 21 from the free throw line, Northfield
yeah.
ought to be fouling
yeah,
right now.
You're right. Under 2 to play in the game. Rochester up 52-45.
You can't face guard like that. That's illegal.
Murphy out to Holland. Holland against Steffen. Works around the defense. Pulls it back outside. She loses the handle. Now out to Keaton Stasiak. Stasiak holds. Rochester guys are down by 4 with 11 seconds to play in that game at Rochester High School. Murphy holds in the center circle with 90 seconds to play in the game. Up 52-45. Murphy around the defense. Pass down Luna Pollock is going to be tied up between she and Reed, and Northfield going to get it back. Man, they had a perfect opportunity to push this lead to 9.
The ball was behind Pollock on the pass. Reed was able to get a hand on it.
A minute 24 to play in the game. Rochester up 52-45. Lady Zebras in a man-to-man pressure. Reed looks to get it in. Goes ahead to Lemming. Lemming picks up her dribble. Now gives the head to Steffen with a minute 20. To Eckert. Eckert loses the handle. Rochester picks it up on the turnover. Now Malco with the basketball. A minute 15. Bounce pass ahead to Holland. A minute 10. Crosses the timeline. She is fouled on the reach-in by Steffen. Holland will go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Steffen done for the evening.
So Steffen is done. Coach Salmon will have to go to his bench, and it'll either be Pease or Tiefaber, I'm guessing. And both of those young ladies have played really well.
Yeah, I would, Pease would get my vote. She really did a good job in the second quarter coming off the bench.
Instead, it's going to be Pete Tiefaber. So Holland at the line to shoot one and the bonus, looking to push this lead to 9. A minute 8 to play in the basketball game. X ties the first one. Let's apply. Good.
Sophomore's got 5 points tonight, all coming from the free throw line.
5 big ones. Holland with one more. 53-48 Rochester. 68 seconds to play in the game. Second one's good again. 3 timeouts by both teams. Tiefaber runs it up the floor, runs it away from Holland, picks up a dribble now to Eckert. Eckert works the right side against Pollock, and then has her pass tipped away and stolen by Holland. Holland pulls it out, runs away from the defense, and Reed commits a foul. She just fouled out.
Yep. She's going to finish with 4.
The Rochester guys falls to Northfield tonight, 42-37. So a hard-fought game at Rochester High School tonight. It goes to Northfield, 42-37, the final. Holland at the line for 1 in the bonus. First one is good. As it rolls around, and Rochester by 10 now at 55-45 with 54 seconds to play in the game. Again, each team with 3 timeouts. X with 1 more for the Lady Zebras. Ties the second one. No good. And the rebound tipped around, and Murphy comes out of there with it. Murphy then is fouled by Eckert, who pushes her to the ground.
And the entire crowd looking for an intentional foul, but they're not going to get it.
Well, the foul occurred, then it was a kind of a...
So Eckert picks up her 3rd.
Rochester by 10 with 48.6 to play in the game. Murphy at the free throw line for 2.
Murphy has not scored in this second half. She had 11 in the first half.
First one on the way for the senior. Yep.
Rochester back out to their largest lead of the game.
This is about ready to set up a huge game on Wednesday.
If we get there.
Your glass always half empty. Second one's good by Murphy. 12-point lead for Rochester. Thompson loses the basketball. Now gives to Eckert with 45. Ahead to Tiefaber. Tiefaber then is fouled by Holland with 40.9 to play in the game, and that's going to send Northfield to the line for 1 and the bonus. Rochester up by 12 at 57-45. Well, the difference of this game is the foul trouble that Northfield got into early in the first half.
I would agree with that. And had Rochester been better from the free throw line,
yeah, you're right.
This game wouldn't even have been close.
Key Faber's shot, no good. Paul with the rebound, gives to X with 38. X then is fouled by Thompson, and she'll go back to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras, who lead by 12 with 36.8 to play in the game. Again, just moments ago, the Northfield guys defeated the Rochester Zebras at home. What did I say?
42-37.
42-37, yeah. Holland with two. First one is good for the sophomore. Boy, it wasn't pretty free throw shooting in the first half, and when Rochester's needed it, and how many times have we seen that this year?
Well, Holland, yeah, 6 of 7 here in the fourth quarter. Murphy hit a couple here in the fourth quarter.
Eckert is done. Her senior season comes going in here at Northfield High School, well, the regular season anyway.
She's going to finish with 10 points.
Second one is good by Holland. Rochester now up by 14 at 59-45, and Coach Stasiak clears the bench. Stasiak's done. Malco is done. Garrison and Odell and Van Meter into the game. 33. Thompson goes left side, backs away in, loses the handle with 29. Gives to a cutting Key Faber, and she's found on the shot by the Rochester Zebras with 27.5 to play in the game.
So Abbott picks up a second foul.
So Hef just sent me a score that it surprises me a little bit. LaVille guys beat Culver tonight, 79-62. Thumped Culver tonight.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a big score. First one in for Key Faber is good. And Olivia Williams comes into the game for the first time tonight, and she spells X. Now, Olivia Williams had 7 in the JV game. The JV game went to Northfield over Rochester 44-21. Key Faber with one more. Second one is good again. 59-47, full-court press by Northfield. Bounce pass comes into Garrison against Lemming. Back to Abbott. Abbott through the center circle with 20. Now near the scores table with 19. She dribbles with 18. Northfield going to let her dribble. She's at the timeline. And the center circle and dribbles with 10. Abbott dribbles with 9. Northfield not going to foul. They're going to let the clock run out. The Rochester Zebras keep their hopes of a conference championship alive by going on the road on this Friday night and defeating Northfield by 12, 59-47. Post-game thoughts coming up after this on 92.1 WROI.